Good morning, guys. Thank you for joining me. Here's an update about that earthquake swarm that is occurring off the coast of Oregon near Coos Bay. Of all the years that I've been monitoring and watching for earthquakes, I have never seen an event off the Blanco fracture zone of so many earthquakes. In the last day, there's been 52 earthquakes, the largest being a magnitude 5.8. 7 people said they felt this earthquake. There was a smaller earthquake yesterday at 5.5, where 11 people said they felt that one. So I think what's going on is people just are not reporting them to USGS. We have one report here from Depot Bay there. It says Lincoln County, I believe, not far from Salem. Another report from Newport. Another report from Walport. And another report from Florence. The first wave of the earthquake came from the north. Tension was applied. Going west, the fault did some spreading and slight dipping towards the east. That is the movement of the fault zone. All earthquakes have been listed as 10 kilometers or 6.2 miles in depth. USGS often does that when they don't know for sure how deep the earthquakes are. Looking at the different earthquakes, we actually got 2 5.8s. This other one, 4 people reportedly felt it. This one here was at 4:36 p.m. yesterday, local time. And those reports came from Waldport. The first of several 5.5s, 14 people now have said that they felt that earthquake. It was originally 11 yesterday. That one was at 1:30 p.m. local time. And it looks like they updated their felt report since yesterday. One report from Springfield near Eugene. Another report from Florence. Waldport. Another one from Waldport. A report from Cloverdale. Sheridan. Troutdale. Beaverton. Forest Grove. Portland, not to be confused with the other Portland. And Seaside and La Center. Now the Blanco fracture zone, and I got that drawn out here. It is a plate boundary between the Juan de Fuca plate and the Gorda plate, which is down over here. The Gorda plate is making a rotation, a counterclockwise rotation, as it slides underneath the North American plate, going towards the east. This is an area, a rising center, where they have spreading. And scientists say for individual earthquakes, well, we're not having individual earthquakes, there is no threat for a Cascadia earthquake subduction zone to create a tsunami. They say that the Blanco fracture zone is just too far away to cause additional stress for the Cascadia subduction zone. But that's for individual earthquakes, not a swarm like we're currently having. The Blanco fracture zone is a right lateral strike slip fault, meaning the top here on the north side moves right and the bottom moves left. The spreading is mostly northeast to southwest. This fault zone is over 200 miles long, extending almost all the way down to Cape Blanco, Coos Bay, etc. I haven't been able to find any data about if this fault zone ever had a complete rupture. If it did do that, yeah, it would be devastating. These canyons are very deep from past earthquakes. There's sediment, some of it very deep. And another article that I did find on Science Daily says that the Blanco Transform Fault Zone won't likely produce the huge earthquake many have predicted for the Pacific Northwest because it isn't a subduction zone fault. But The scientists say an earthquake of magnitude 6.5 to 7 is possible, if not probable, in the near future. And their analysis suggests that the region may be under some tectonic stress that could affect the Cascadia subduction zone. Now, this article is from 2008, and back then there was a swarm of 600 earthquakes in 10 days, including a magnitude 5.4 and a 5.0 event. Well, the recent earthquakes have actually been larger. They've been as large as a magnitude 5.8. Our monitors may have missed a lot of earthquakes that are less than a 3.0. The western side of the fault may be experiencing a series of mini quakes that we can't detect, or it could be slowly creeping along in a way that we can't measure. But we can't discount the possibility that this energy hasn't been released, and it will someday in the form of a good-sized earthquake. The risk of a major tsunami from an earthquake in this transform fault is slim, scientists point out, because the plates move sideways past each other. You need quite a bit of vertical displacement on the ocean floor to generate a tsunami. The earthquakes along the Blanco Fault don't generate it. As I did in my report yesterday, when there was only 6 earthquakes at that time, I stated that stress has built and there is more earthquakes to come. Will there be a large earthquake that creates a tsunami? Well, according to that one report, yeah, it could create stress along the Cascadia Fault Zone. Geology is in its infancy. There's a lot they don't know. And I only report the information that I can find. It should be a wake-up call that people should be prepared for a large earthquake. You just don't know. That is one long fault zone, 200 miles in length. Has it ever had a full rupture? I don't know. Maybe one of you guys can find something that's buried in all that information. Please put your information down below. Thank you very much for watching. Thank you for subscribing. Please stay safe, and I'll talk to you later. God bless you all. Bye.